Dwelling place for you is another practice we would regularly perform. It was our way of celebrating and giving thanks for the gift of the other, a way of honoring our call to live for the sake of the other, our duty to care for the other. It was also a way of honoring our own existence as an other in need of care. It was, too, a way of experiencing the grace of giving and the grace of receiving, grace upon grace. Two of us would come together. Sometimes we would perform this practice for us alone, and sometimes a small group of people would come to watch and bear witness to this practice. One of us would bring some objects that they had found in the days prior, some dried leaves, a few small stones, a bowl of water. These would become, through our care and attention, transformed into musical instruments. One of us would bring a poem that they had discovered, or perhaps written. This poem would be transformed into song. We would sit on the floor or at a table, facing each other. The objects and the poem would be lovingly laid out between us. To begin, one of us would sing the poem to the other. The singing would be very quiet and gentle and free, traces and memories of distant songs. We would offer this song freely and openly just for the other, as if saying, in this song I have created a dwelling place just for you. The one being serenaded would bask in this private dwelling place, listening deeply to the one singing. It seemed to us that this listening was also a gift being offered for the sake of another, a way of tending to another. Singer and listener, both giving and receiving, grace upon grace. While listening, we would find some way of allowing our listening to be transformed into playing by exploring one of the sound sources before us. Another gift, grace upon grace. We would then switch roles. Once we had both experienced the gift of singing and the gift of being sung to, as well as the gift of listening and the gift of being listened to, we would then sing the poem together. We would sing in rhythmic unison. Sometimes one of us would lead, sometimes the other. Sometimes the poem would lead us both. Sometimes we would sing in unison and sometimes in harmony, but never thinking about it, always just surrendering to the experience, together and apart, both of us giving and receiving the gifts of singing and listening, grace upon grace. And as we sang, we would, each in our own way, find ways of accompanying each other by exploring the newly transformed instruments before us. When we were finished this, we would sit together in silence, still treasuring this experience in our hearts. This silence, too, another gift, grace upon grace. Until it felt time to leave this place.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.